Hey everybody, here's a market report for the first week of September. So this week in real estate, current active listings on the market is 558. As I'm sure that you've heard, this is incredibly low inventory. We should be definitely double this, if not triple this amount in a typical year in a balanced market. The median list price right now is $239,900, and that's around $125 a square foot. That number we see kind of inching up each month, particularly by each quarter. The absorption rate right now, there's 2.12 months of inventory. For a balanced market, that would be around six. And pre-COVID, we ran between 6 and 8. Median sold price is $177,518 year to date. So from January to the 1st of September through August, $177,000 is the median sold price. And then the median rental price also year to date. So January to through August to September is around $1,100 for the median rental price. And these are from rentals that are listed on the MLS. So I know that's only a small portion of them, but it gives us some idea about how those prices are changing. Year over year, this is up 18%. Year over year, the median sold price is up only 2%. So that definitely shows that things are kind of balancing out in that price appreciation that we've seen over the last several years. Last week, there were 76 new listings with a median list price of $199,975, and that's at $125 a square foot. even though there are fewer sales, fewer houses closing, the continued inching up of list prices and sale prices are causing those numbers to still look like they're accelerating, but there definitely is a cooling off happening in the market. There are 82 pending. Our pending median is around $117 a square foot. Last week, 5 expired. This is an incredibly low number. These do typically at the end of the month. So the beginning of the month is really when the lowest numbers of expired happen. The end of the month is when they typically expire, that those expirations go up, but we're seeing fewer and fewer houses expire. The ones that did expire last week, their median price was $355 and they were listed at $150 a square foot. We're definitely seeing that price being priced correctly is the absolute sell or don't sell, but that's probably pretty typical for most real estate markets. Price reductions, there were 52, seen more and more. The median was were price reductions from houses around 250,000 were reduced to 225,000. 39 houses closed last week. $115 a square foot was their median. And 19 came back on the market. One of the things I think I'm noticing as a real estate agent is that the transactions from contract to close are becoming a little bit bumpier. There, a lot of things are happening. People are losing their financing at the last minute. A lot of things coming up on inspections. The buyer sentiment is changing quite a bit in this as the market shifts. We're seeing just much pickier buyers. Buyers are taking more time, not quite that crazy, throw all your money at a deal and hope for the best. So I think that's a good thing, is it can be more difficult for sellers, but at the same time, we need some balance in this market. What's hot on the market right now? If it's clean, it's neat, it's updated, and it's been remodeled, it is still selling in hours or just a few days. South side seems to have is a little bit hotter than the north side. Around the state streets are very popular right now. Anything that is VA or FHA ready, those buyers have been kind of knocked out of the market for a really long time. So there's still a real backlog of VA and FHA buyers. So any house that is ready and will qualify for those kinds of financing are incredibly hot right now. Also, the single story ranch is really the go-to house. So I think that has to do with some of the aging population, people downsizing, no longer wanting stairs. 1,500 to 1,700 square feet is a very popular size right now. what's not hot. Poor workmanship flips. Buyers are really paying close attention to things that have been updated and were they done well or were they done poorly. So I think some of those poor workmanship flips are really sitting and not selling quite as well and not getting the interest from buyers. Anything that needs rehab or remodel is being passed over. I think that buyers understand that it's really difficult still to find contractors and to get work done and the expense of that. They don't want to manage those jobs. So houses that are updated and remodeled are definitely hotter than those that need rehab or remodel. And also two-story houses or houses with stairs, which goes kind of with that aging population and downsizing that we sort of have. That's a high demand area is people who are wanting to age in place and have their final home destination that's easy to take care of it. All the important stuff is done and new. It's efficient and easy to live in. So that's just some notes from the Suites market. I'm going to try and do these every week. So that's going to be my challenge to keep up with some market information. If there's any particular numbers that you'd like for me to look into, I'm happy to do that. So give me some feedback. Let me know what you like and what's helpful for you. Hope you guys have a great week.